So my work starts with drawing. So the person that's drawing and the person that are sculpting are actually almost kind of two different people. I'm not considering how a sculpture is made when I draw. And so it's kind of the magic of this other talent side of mine to try to make them into wood. So like this is the sculpture and that's the drawing. Most of my work is in this realm of what I guess you could call biomorphic abstraction, but I often interpret it in terms of reproduction, death, disease, decomposition, sexuality. And then on top of that, I think, especially recently, there is a latent kind of cybernetic vibe, so that we're looking at nature, but also nature as it's aided by technology somehow. One of the things that's most important in my work is the kind of intersection of the materials and how the materials feel soft, that it's actually, you actually get the feeling that it's not wood, that it might be some sort of soft material, but almost all of this is made out of wood. I often work singularly like this in discrete sculptures, but the real passion of mine is to work with all the works in concert, where I'm presenting a series of objects in a kind of ordered procession in which somehow an idea builds upon itself as it changes from the front to the back of an installation. So for a body of work like this, like I had always thought of this work as being about the gestation of any sort of organism from birth to death. And so you're starting out at the front of this over there with like the beginning of an organism, the splitting of the chromosomes, the penetration of how it happened, the splitting of the eggs, the twinning, like all this kind of stuff that happens in nature. Of course, it's not didactic, so my reading is actually just an example of a possible reading, but I think that the building blocks of the language are there. The soft material, the way that things fit into each other, that they transmit an idea that has something to do with life cycle or the small circle of living matter. But I often work in organizations of installations to try to apply some sort of logic. And then once you're in the exhibition, you're free to kind of look at the sculptures as discrete objects, that they themselves embody their own concepts or associations.